Hi, I'm Carissa from the Buell Planetarium at Carnegie Science Center. Welcome to the Something to Watch series, where we offer fun and educational science videos for kids, parents, and teachers. Like the rest of the Science Center team, I am currently at home, practicing social distancing. And like many others, I'm passing some of my time with a little game called Animal Crossing New Horizons. This social simulator came out on March 20th, and it's been such a great way to stay connected with friends and explore a fun virtual world. Animal Crossing has a large focus on collecting items for its museum, like bugs, fossils, and fish. These collections are vast and based off of very real-life things. But the game also has an aspect that hits home for me as someone who works in the planetarium, space. In the game, there's a great character named Celeste, a friendly owl who shares stories of the sky, lets you know how to best watch a meteor shower, and will give you recipes to build an array of, well, celestial items. Sadly, there's no planetarium in the world of Animal Crossing to showcase these items, so I took it upon myself to build a little space annex to my museum, and I'd love to take you all on a tour. Our first stop is the iconic Saturn V, the most powerful rocket ever built. This is a model of the vehicle used by NASA for the Apollo missions, sending man to the moon. While the Saturn V isn't very big here, in real life it stands about 363 feet tall, taller than the Statue of Liberty. Most of its size is to hold the huge amount of fuel needed to launch from the Earth and reach the moon. Only the tiny silver cone on top made the entire round trip. Our next stop, naturally, is the moon. This model of the moon looks to showcase a pretty accurate map of the lunar surface, including many of its recognizable features. The dark areas are called maria, the Latin word for seas. The seas of the moon aren't made of water, though. These dark plains formed when lava cooled during the moon's formation. There are also some of the moon's larger craters visible. It certainly captures the magic of seeing a full moon shining bright in the sky. A smaller segment of the Saturn V, this is an Apollo Command and Service Module, or CSM. This stage of the Saturn V carried the command module, the silver cone, which fit perfectly the three crew members, and the service module, the white cylinder, which held necessary fuel to maneuver the crew in lunar orbit. Definitely a cozy ride. To land on the moon, the astronauts needed another special spacecraft, the Lunar Module, or LEM. The LEM was what was piloted down to the surface by two crew members, while the third remained in the CSM. The LEM would touch down and serve as the crew's living quarters for the duration of the mission. It was about 30 feet wide and 22 feet tall, but inside was pretty cramped quarters for those moonwalkers. It would later blast off from the lunar surface to meet back up with the CSM, which would carry all three astronauts back home to Earth. For the last three Apollo missions, Apollo 15, 16, and 17, a lunar roving vehicle also went along for the ride. This lightweight, battery-powered moon buggy would allow the astronauts to cover more ground and carry back more samples as they explored the moon's surface. The game also features a large radio antenna, which reminded me of the radio dishes we use here on Earth to communicate with spacecraft. Dishes like this one help make up the Deep Space Network, which spans the globe with stations in California, Spain, and Australia, and allows mission scientists to talk to various spacecraft all throughout our solar system at all hours of the day, and in the case of the Voyager probes, even beyond our solar system. What's really cool, at home, you can see for yourself exactly which spacecraft the DSN is talking to right now by visiting eyes.nasa.gov/DSN. Whether it's collecting spacecraft, wishing on meteor showers, creating tiny lab coats because you miss wearing your work uniform, or simply whacking your friends with a star-shaped net, there's a lot of cosmic fun to enjoy in Animal Crossing. Let us know your favorite way to explore space in this game in the comments. To learn more, come see our show Fly Me to the Moon in the Planetarium when the Science Center reopens. Log on to carnegiesciencecenter.org for more things to watch, things to read, and things to do at home.